Hey friends, Gatormom here. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're having a great week. Today we're talking all about this MINA BAIE Emmy in the MIDI size. Alright, so a while back I did a review on the Emmy in the full size nylon here. I'll link it below for those of you that haven't seen it. But I was really excited when MINA BAIE released the MIDI size in this Emmy style because it is perfect. It is such a good size, especially for someone like me that's more of a, I don't want to say a minimal packer, like let's be honest, like I pack all the things, but with having older kids now, I don't need quite as much as I needed when I was potty training or when my kids needed like bottles and changes of clothes and all of the things, right? So I don't need a big, massive type bag anymore. I still love the regular size Emmy. I think it's great for travel or like longer days out when I need extra snacks or activities and things for the kids. But the MIDI size is perfect for every day. It's a really awesome bag. And what I like about it is there's not many bags out there that pack horizontally anymore. Like a lot of them I feel like pack vertically, and a lot of the pockets aren't really as easy to get to as all of them are inside this MIDI Emmy. Like when you open up the bag, you'll see here in a second, you have so many pockets on the inside and it organizes like a dream. Like it's really, really good. I have it here in the vegan leather. This is the first time I've tried any of MINA BAIE's vegan leather. I typically will get all of their things in either the nylon or the full grain leather, which is a dream. I love their leather. All of their things are just really, really good quality, like their zippers, their straps, all of that. So I was excited to kind of try out their vegan leather and it did not disappoint at all. I've been using this for a couple of weeks now and it has gotten soft and slouchy and beautiful. I love this shorter strap option that you have on this bag because it fits so comfortably underneath my arm that I can just kind of grab it and throw it over my shoulder and be hands-free, like instantly. I also really like the two grab handles here at the top. I find myself using these a ton when I'm grabbing the bag. And then last but not least, you have the option to wear this bag backpack strap. Like, so I typically will just kind of keep the straps on here so that I can go ahead and throw it over my back whenever I need to or use the shoulder strap. So I alternate from both of them from time to time. But if you don't like them flopping around back here, you can of course detach them here with the clips and then you'll just have your shoulder strap or your grab handle option. So lots of different ways that you can carry the bag. I'm gonna go ahead and put the camera down, unpack the bag, show you all of the organization details, and then at the very end, do a couple of side-by-sides of the MIDI size here versus this full-size nylon. Now, last I checked, but it like alternates all the time on their website, but I'm not sure that this bag is currently in stock, but I know that they have a pre-order for a couple of different ones of this MIDI Emmy, I believe. I think it might be on pre-order for this black nylon version of it. Like I said, I'm not 100%, so it just really depends on when you watch this video as to if they have this exact one in stock. They always restock, it's just a matter of when. I'll of course have all of the details down below so you can get on their like email list and all of that and know when things are restocking. So let's go ahead and get on into this Emmy so I can show you how I have it packed up. All right, so I went ahead and removed these backpack straps here on the back of the bag, but I wanted to go ahead and show you a little bit of an up close of what the hardware and this strap here looks like, so that you can see how good the quality is. You have MINA BAIE just kind of etched right in the hardware there, which I think is really cool. So they're easily adjustable and they have this little kind of loop down here at the bottom to keep the strap from like coming undone. So it's really comfortable to wear on your back. The top corners of this bag has a natural kind of fold down there, as you can see. So it gives it a really soft, like hobo look when you're wearing it with this short strap here. On the front of the bag, you do have one big magnetic closure pocket.
It's just a really strong magnet. It goes almost the whole way down in the front of the bag there. I typically will use this pocket just to throw my cell phone in here or like face masks or anything like that. It fits in there great vertically or horizontally. I actually had it kind of tucked down in there. So that gives you a good idea like how big that pocket is. Then you have MINA BAIE in gold right here, which is just very subtle but classic looking. I really like the logo there. On the sides of the bag, you have two big pockets. They are not insulated, but they are so big and wide. In this one over here, I actually just have a handful of face masks. I have our kitchen masks and then my son's just kind of regular mask here. I was just throwing all of our masks in here whenever we need them and then had some extra in there as well. But the pocket is huge. It's a really nice size pocket. Over here in this one, I actually just have a water bottle at the moment. This is just a regular size water bottle, so kind of gives you an idea of the size, but you can fit larger water bottles in the side of here. Also, they'll just stick up a little bit depending on how high you have one. So great pockets for that. On the back here, I'll give you just a quick look. You don't have any pockets or anything like that. You just have the rings here for the optional backpack straps, but I did want to show you what that looked like as well. You have two zipper pulls here at the main opening of the bag. They're nice, smooth zippers, just like you're used to with all MINA BAIE items. And the bag opens up nice and wide. Like the material is just so good. Like it's really, really soft and squishy, and you can just really see everything that you have packed inside at all times. Like I love to just be able to look down and grab anything that I need. And you can choose to pack it with pouches. I have a few in here, as you can see, or you don't need to at all because they're, oh my goodness, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 pockets inside here. So you definitely have all of the internal organization for sure. So I'm gonna go ahead and start pulling everything out like I typically do. Everything that I'm mentioning today that I have in the bag, and of course, this bag is gonna be linked below. So you'll have no worries about finding anything that I mention. Back here, I just have my Erin Condren notebook, which you guys have been seeing a little bit lately. This is a 7x9 just lined notebook. And then right in front of that is a book that I'm still reading. I'm almost done with it. I'm about halfway or so. It's Growing Boldly by Emily Lay. I typically don't carry a book in my bags with me. It's usually just like my notebook or my planner, but this one I've really been liking and I've been reading it just like at sports practice and car line and stuff like that. So it's been nice having it in my bag when I have room. Then right in front of that there, I just have my Simplify weekly planner that I've been back in and enjoying that as well. Attached to the key leash that's inside the bag here, I actually have a large link pouch from MZ Wallace, and it is the perfect size for my Touchland hand sanitizer. You guys know I love these. It's just a power mist sanitizer and it fits great inside this little pouch here. I decided that I would go ahead and just link it on this key leash because it's easy to grab in and out, but I could easily just kind of put that on the outside of the bag if I really wanted to, but that's what I have attached on that one. Then kind of moving around the pockets here, we'll start with these two side pockets. This one over here, I just have my keys tucked inside. I have my gold bamboo silicone Oventure ring with all of my, actually both of my car keys, because I had the spare in my car and I didn't want to leave it in there. So I have my car keys in there. And then over here in this pocket, I have a ton of snacks. I just have mainly things for me, but I have some pretzels and granola bars, a couple of bars for the kids if they need something. And I just have a ton of that kind of stuff tucked down in that pocket. Now I can easily, even with the items that I have in here, especially if I take that book out, I can stick an activity pack in here for the kids and I'm good to go. Like I don't need to unpack my entire bag for just things for myself versus things for them. So it's kind of packed for both. Like for example, I'll go ahead and pull out what's in this back pouch here. This is my Keep Going first aid kit, which I always have when I have the kids with me. I love that it has this kind of soft strap attached to it. And on the inside, I'll just show you guys briefly what it looks like. It's almost like a book. It opens up perfectly. It just has on-the-go things like scissors, antibiotic ointment, band-aids. There's so much in here. And then I added a couple things in this back mesh pocket that I know we need sometimes, like hair ties, our little soap sheets, pills, things like that. So This is mainly for the kids, but as you can see, I just carry it around every day with me so I can make sure that I have it. Then right next to it over here in this little pocket, I have my 31 mini zipper pouch with my little photo fob that I'm obsessed with. If you guys are still looking for like Mother's Day gift ideas, I think this is just the sweetest. I love it. And there's actually different sizes in this photo fob. Like there's square ones, rectangular shapes, and then different colors on the back too. So this one here, I think I've showed you guys a bunch, but in case you've missed it, I'll show you it up close. It's just a picture of my family. I'm obsessed with it. Unzipping this pouch here, you can see I just have a bunch of small little cosmetic things for me, like a portable hairbrush, some pills, chapstick. I have a bunch of these Tarte lip glosses that I love, vitamin C packs, more hair ties. It's just a ton of small little things that I need when I'm on the go. Right behind those two back pouches or pockets, there's one zipper pocket, and it is nice and big with a smooth zipper. The only thing I have down in there is a package of wet wipes and tissues. I actually had another pack of tissues, but we went through the whole thing, so I just decided to tuck those down there so they're easy for me to grab since we've been eating them a ton lately with all of the allergies. I'm gonna turn the bag around so that you can see what this side of the bag looks like. It's so awesome. I love the design on this bag, and it's similar in most MINA BAIE's. A couple of like my Stevie, for example, my MIDI Harper, it has like a side of the bag that's designed similar to this, and I love it. So down here at the bottom, you have two elastic pockets. Then you have a small little trimmed leather pocket that's like a little bit smaller, and then you have a small zipper pocket up there. So it's just awesome. You have like so much organization in this one little spot. So right here in this pocket, I have my MZ Wallace wallet. I love this also. This is just the small Crosby, and it holds everything perfectly, like receipts, cards, all the things. So I have that there. Then over here in this pocket, I have a thing of Excedrin. And I also have a little allergy kind of nose spray for my son, and then my portable packed party charger on the go to just charge my phone or iPads or whatever. I always have that with me as well. And then over here, like on the side sticking up, I have my Erin Condren pencil pouch. And inside here, I just have highlighters and pens that I like to use whenever I'm journaling or planning. I also have a highlighter for my book in there. So everything just kind of fits nicely inside this pencil pouch here in that corner. And then I have up here in this small pocket, it is the perfect fit for my hand cream. This one is made by Perfectly Posh, so I have that in that pocket. Then the last but not least, over here in the zipper pocket, I just have my small link pouch from MZ Wallace, and it's the perfect size for my earbuds. So that's why I have kind of tucked down inside that pocket there. I'll give you a quick look here, a little bit more up close on what the inside of the bag here looks like with all of its pockets. I love it. Like, it is just, it's an awesome, awesome bag, and I love the way it organizes. Let me grab the large size Emmy and see if I can show you all how the two of these compare in size. All right, so I grabbed the camera down here so that I can move it a little bit more freely. Looking at these two side by side, they actually look like the same size. I think it's because the nylon is definitely more of a softer material, so it squishes up and kind of falls a little bit easier, whereas this leather is a little bit more stiff. So it's hard to capture them side by side, but you can easily see here that you have a ton more room in the fabric. When you open up the large size Emmy, it's exactly the same as the MIDI Emmy, only it's larger. It's on a larger scale. I really, really like the nylon. And I do believe, don't quote me on this because it's hard to keep track, but I do believe that this nylon is available in this MIDI version also, and vice versa, as far as like the vegan leather on the large size. So it's really just a preference. I love both of them. I really, truly do. It just depends which one that you all like. So this here, like I said, is the large one. I have a full review on that one, and then I'll give you one last look of what the MIDI looks like there on the inside. Let me flip them this way really quickly and kind of show you possibly next to each other this way. can kind of see. They look so similar in size on camera, but one is definitely bigger than the other. So there you have it. I hope this review was helpful for those of you that are considering this MIDI Emmy size from MINA BAIE. I will have everything that I talked about today linked below. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to reach out. I'll see you on my next video. Have a great day.